So when you're a developer working with NEOS, there's probably one name which always comes up again when you use certain packages to improve your website. There are lots of packages probably you've already used, who's authored also by Martin. Martin Fitzel is presenting the next talk, and he's a backend developer at Zeitgeist NEOS Solutions in Hamburg. And I think for 3 years now, he focused his work almost exclusively on NEOS and Flow. And as far as I know, he's still very happy with this decision. So in 2016, he joined the NEOS team, where he's working to extend the possibilities of the NEOS Fusion rendering layer. So lots of Fusion was authored by him, including the Atomic Fusion edition. So Martin lives in Hamburg with 2 kids and his girlfriend, and besides work, he likes nature and climbing. So that's also something we did together at some NEOS sprints. Right. So the next talk will be about forms with NEOS Fusion and AFX, a recent addition also to the NEOS core. So be excited about the next talk. Martin Fitzel with forms and NEOS Fusion and AFX.
Hello NEOS Conference, I'm really happy to talk to you again, but I would love to see you in person. Somehow I miss meeting other people, especially the NEOS community and the NEOS team. A year ago, keeping distance from other people sounded like something I might enjoy, but that has changed. Being a NEOS team member is great fun, there is only a little drawback. Maybe it's a personal thing, but as team member, I feel responsible to have an answer to all questions, or at least be able to point into a specific direction. I love NEOS and want others to do the same, so I want to make their NEOS experience as great as mine. Luckily, people tend to ask who is known for working in a specific area. So the questions that I get asked very often are related to the rendering layer of NEOS. If this is the case, my answers very often sound like, use AFX and sprinkle it with a little vanilla Fusion, plus a little code snippet I had laying around. I love this. It's very little work, it helps, and the code is usually very expressive due to the declarative nature of Fusion. However, there has been a topic where I was not able to give helpful answers for some years, and this has been forms. That would be fine if it was an exotic topic, but somehow every customer needs contact forms or newsletter registrations and sometimes much more. So whenever I was asked about forms, the answer I usually had to give was more like, it's complicated, with a notion of what kind of pane do you prefer? The reason for that is when forms are rendered with AFX, all the comfort Flow usually offers is lost. On the other hand, one could use the existing forms with YAML configurations, but you would have a real hard time to integrate any type of custom rendering. This is exceptionally bad if the main selling point for NEOS is custom rendering, which is the case at Zeitgeist. Another problem is that configuration-based forms do not integrate well into our development process, where usually the front-end is developed first. And this is why I want to talk with you about forms with Fusion and AFX. But why is it complicated in the first place? In the end, forms are a bunch of HTML tags, and for those we already have AFX, correct? While this is technically true, it clearly underestimates the complexity of forms and also how many convenience features of Flow exist that developers are used to. It took 2 years and about 3 rewrites to explore the topic and iterate on various approaches until the Neos Fusion form package finally ended up in the shape that was just released together with Neos 7.1. Since the topic is quite large, I will split the talk into 2 main sections about form rendering with Fusion and runtime forms with steps and actions. So without further ado, let's dive right in. Form rendering. Before we can talk about handling form results, we obviously have to render a form in the first place. This seems like a simple task, but once you get into the details, it gets complicated. Even more so if you expect comfort and flexibility. So what features are actually needed to render a form in Neos? First, we must specify where the form shall be sent to. HTML expects an action attribute, and on the Flow side we usually have a controller action, so we have to connect those two. Then we obviously have to render the HTML input fields that manipulate the data, and we need labels for those fields that have to be translated into the current language. But there are less visible requirements as well. Oftentimes, forms manipulate existing objects, so we have to configure the data to modify. We also have to ensure that the form fields use the data from those bound objects, and we have to transfer all object identifiers as hidden fields to the target controller. For so-called unsafe requests, we need a hidden CSRF token to prevent session hijacking. And we also have to add a signed trusted properties token that allows the property mapper to convert the submitted values back to objects on the target controller. Once the form is submitted, the target controller will validate the input, which can lead to validation errors, and so we additionally need the referrer information, so Flow can decide to render the last request instead, in which case the form has to be rendered with the previously submitted values that were partially invalid. And we have to show the user what went wrong, so we need translated error messages. Just take a moment and let this sink a bit. All this is needed for a simple form, and I am sure there are pieces missing. In the past, this job was mainly done by the Fluid Form View helpers. To have all this available in Fusion and AFX, we created the Neos Fusion Form package as it was released in version 1 together with Neos 5.1. The good news is, you do not have to care about all this unless you are interested, regardless whether you are using Fluid Form or Fusion Form. To be honest, I myself learned about some of those features just while working on Fusion Form. Now let us compare a simple form in Fluid and then have a look at the AFX version. The form manipulates a customer object and sends it to the save action. Rendering this form in AFX does not look that different, which is good news. The prototype names are a bit longer, but for those we nowadays have really good IDE support. Structurally, it is exactly the same. But Neos would not be Neos if we simply had re-implemented the API of the Fluid Form View helpers in AFX. Once we are rewriting stuff, we always try to improve, and the Fluid Form View helpers contained some weirdness we wanted to change for a long time. So, what is new or has been changed in regards to Fluid Forms? Fluidform view helpers have 32 possible properties, which cause a lot of confusion. There are properties like arguments, additional attributes, or additional params, which are almost impossible to differentiate. We wanted a clear distinction between all configurations that control automatic functionality on the one hand and those that set HTML attributes directly on the other hand. For the Fusion Form prototype, we ended up with only three Fusion properties. Form, which configures all automatic and comfort functionality. Attributes, which allows to define generic tag attributes and overrides all magic. And content, which is the form body and will usually be AFX or a Fusion prototype. Of course, this is a bit unfair since Fusion allows to define structured APIs and form and attributes are Fusion prototypes that have their own properties as well, but still, the API is much more streamlined, more flexible, with a clear isolation of all magic. Fluid forms allowed to configure a single object that is modified by the form. While this is often enough, in many cases, more than one object is modified at a time. Over the years, I've seen quite a bit of form request objects that had the sole purpose of combining objects together for being manipulated in a single form. This is kind of sad because Flow can handle multiple arguments for controllers without problems, since ever. The solution was not to bind single objects to the form, but generic data, which is a Fusion data structure and can combine multiple objects by using named keys. The side effect is that the field names now contain the object name as well, which is a bit of extra typing, but also improves the overall readability. So, with Fusion Form, you can manipulate multiple objects for the target controller at once. For visual consistency, forms should have a unified way to render field labels and error messages. However, it is not feasible to add those to the control element rendering, since almost every form has multiple exceptions from these rules, be it multiple inputs for one label, like with checkboxes, or buttons without a label at all. For Fusion Form, this was solved by creating a field container prototype that is responsible just for rendering and translating of labels and error messages. The controls are passed to the field container as content. Since the field container already has an understanding of what the current field is, the input elements can reuse this and do not need a separate field definition. This is especially handy once you have multiple checkboxes or radio buttons which are bound to the same property. This is basically anything you have to know to replace Fluid Form View Helpers with Fusion Form and AFX. But what can we actually do with those features so far? Obviously, we can render forms in Fusion with data binding and connect them to flow controller actions. This also allows us to create whole flow projects with Fusion and AFX. At Zeitgeist, we have quite some experience with that, and until now, we never missed Fluid. We can also create whole backend modules for NEOS just with Fusion and AFX. For example, the login and the history module of NEOS itself are already implemented that way. A nice side effect is that we can define forms or parts of forms as presentational Fusion components, which can be previewed with style guides like Zeitgeist Monocle. That's it about form rendering. While form rendering clearly is the baseline, the term forms in NEOS and Flow has yet another meaning, which is the runtime functionality offered by the NEOS form package. This package allows to define a single or multi-step form by YAML configuration. The results are then passed to finishers, which are configured in the same YAML file as the whole form. Having all the configuration in YAML settings makes a lot of sense for a flow application, but a modern NEOS is mostly controlled by Fusion, so after some experiments it was decided not only to replace the rendering of the NEOS form package, but rather add the runtime functionality to the NEOS Fusion form package itself. But what do we actually have to configure? What makes a runtime form? The central building block for runtime form is the so-called process. This is responsible for taking the initial data and the submitted values, for validating the input, and once finished, for returning the resulting data. This final data is then used to perform an action, which is a fancy term for anything. How does it look code-wise? The runtime form is a Fusion prototype that is controlled by four main properties. The namespace defines a prefix for all field names to distinguish the form data from other submitted values. Data sets initial values for the form fields. As mentioned before, the process is what will render the form, handle the submitted arguments, collect data until it declares itself finished, and finally, the action, which is performed after the end of the process. Now, let's have a look what happens inside of the process. What is a process responsible for? A process is a PHP class implementing the process interface, which has to be able to accept the initial data, to handle submitted data, to tell whether it is finished, in which case it has to return the resulting data for the action, or otherwise render the form with error messages if the validation failed. That is all the process interface requires. In total, it's four methods and two arguments. By far, the most forms I came across used only a single step, so we created a dedicated single-step process that is also the default. The single-step process allows to configure content, schema, header, and footer. The content defines the body of the form and will usually be AFX or a Fusion prototype. The schema is responsible for converting the submitted data to the expected types and to validate the result. Header and footer usually need no special configuration unless you need special markups there. A single-step process is finished once the schema is satisfied. After that, the resulting data is made available to the action. The separation of schema and content is the main structural difference when you compare Fusion and YAML forms. It may look like a slight disadvantage at first, but this is what actually makes the integration of custom rendering much easier than before. After the process is finished, the action is performed, which basically fills the same role as the finishers you may be familiar with from YAML forms. Also, the implementations are very similar, so porting finishers to Fusion form actions is straightforward. Having only a single action makes sense from an interface point of view, but in reality, most forms want to perform more than one action, so the default is already an action collection. The NEOS Fusion form package comes with the action type message, redirect, email, and log, which are ports of the finishers from the form package and work almost identical. Only the email action has been extended significantly to support multi-part contents, file uploads, and even create files on the fly by Fusion. You will not need to write a single line of PHP to send a JSON or an XML file in your email. As a side note, the only reason the term action is used instead of finisher is because the interfaces are slightly different and it would be hard to distinguish between finishers for the form or the Fusion form package. Since the finisher interface requires the old form context, there was really no way to make the actions cross-package compatible. Let's have a look at the fusion for that. As everything else, actions are defined by fusion. Each single action is configured by the fusion properties, type, and options. The type is an identifier or a class name. The options configure the details. That approach makes it possible to not only access the submitted data to configure options, but also to use anything else Fusion has access to, like node properties or settings from the configuration. You can even enable or disable actions with Fusion if conditions. At this point, we already covered 95% of the form use cases I have seen in the past. But there is one more thing to take care of, and this is processes with multiple steps. The multi-step process implements the same process interface as the single-step process, but internally it uses a list of single-step processes called steps. Each of those sub-processes has to be finished before the main process considers itself finished. The details are a bit more complicated since the state of the form has to be persisted and it has to be determined which step is to be rendered at a given time. But overall, it is still quite simple. Once the multi-step process is finished, the action is executed in the same way as before, so there are no differences here. How does that look code-wise? First, since the single-step process is the default, it has to be defined explicitly that a multi-step process is to be used. Inside of this process, the property steps contains a collection of single-step processes that work just as in the last example with content and schema. The current state of the process with information which sub-processes exist and which are already finished is available in Fusion as well and can be used to render things like back and forth navigations or a step navigation as form header or footer. So, that's it. It's no rocket engineering and we tried hard to make it as simple as possible, especially for the common use cases. While the Fusion form configuration does not look that different to the classic YAML forms, as it mainly separates rendering and schema and switches YAML for Fusion, the Fusion approach offers some very specific advantages and makes things easy that have been complicated in the past. Since the form content is defined by AFX, every existing Fusion component can be used inside of forms. Think about texts or images to explain things, or about grids to structure the layout of the form. Content, schema, and action can be configured by node properties. That way, editors can configure everything you want them to do. The most simple use case for that is recipient email addresses, but it's not limited to that. Same goes for settings. Since Fusion can access settings, every option or condition can now be controlled by setting. Fusion if conditions allow to enable or disable parts of the form based on any condition. This can be submitted values, data from a previous step, or basically any expression you can think of. By using Fusion prototypes for form content, parts of forms can be reused. That way, it is possible to use a field set or even a whole step in multiple forms. It even is possible to reuse parts in runtime and controller forms, as long as both are rendered by Fusion. By the way, this also creates a migration path from runtime forms to controller forms. This may be useful when requirements evolve over time and what started as a contact form ends up being a whole application. Another advantage of using Fusion prototypes as form content is that you can use style guides like Zeitgeist Monocle to preview and test the sections of the form before integrating them at all. Fusion forms are designed to be as extensible as possible. The whole package itself was built to allow custom rendering in the first place. If you are missing an input type, extend the Fusion Form input prototype and create all the field types you need. If your new type is kind of generic, do not forget to create a pull request for us or to publish it as a package. If you do not like the way labels or errors are rendered, create custom label or error renderer prototypes and configure the translations as fits your need. If you dislike the markup of the field container at all, just create your own field containers from scratch. All this works the same for runtime forms and controller forms. To alter the runtime behavior, you can implement the included PHP interfaces. The most obvious one of them is the action interface that has the same role as the finisher interface in YAML forms. It only contains a single method, which is called perform. There are also interfaces for processes or schemas which may be useful, and especially the process collection interface will be handy once we start implementing node-based forms. Also, while technically not a part of Fusion Forms, it is still important that you can use flow validators with Fusion Forms. Let us look at a practical example before wrapping up. The contact form that is included in the NEOS demo package as it comes with NEOS 7.1 has been rewritten and now uses the Fusion Form runtime. The contact form is a content node type and has properties for configuring things like email recipients or the redirect target after submission. Please note that those fields are optional and the actions will only be active if they are filled. So if you do not need emails, just leave those fields empty. The node type definition for that is pretty standard, so let us jump directly into the Fusion code. The rendering of the contact form is implemented as a content component that uses the runtime form prototype as renderer. A namespace for the form is defined because the argument names look much better that way. Otherwise, a hash would be used as fallback. The content for the single step process is defined as AFX and uses some field container and input elements from the Fusion Form package combined with custom HTML markup. In a larger form, this would probably be defined in a separate prototype, but that is totally up to you. The schema defines the three properties name, email, and message. All of them are required, and the email field has an additional email address validator. The form has a message, email, and redirect action, but for this example, we are only looking at the email action. The email action is only active once subject, recipient, and sender are defined, which is an example of using if conditions for form adjustments. The type identifies the action implementation that is to be used. In this case, it is obviously the email action. The options configure the details. Most of them use node properties and are configurable by editors. Others use the submitted data, which is available in Fusion as well. The reply to address uses the email field, and the send HTML contains the submitted name and message. As I have shown, NEOS Fusion Form implements the feature set of Fluid and YAML forms in general, but takes a different approach in various places. Please do not expect a drop-in replacement. That never was the intention. By using Fusion for rendering and configuration, we introduced many new ways to configure and control forms. Fusion prototypes allow reusing of forms or parts of forms on many levels. The cool thing is that most of those new features emerged after using Fusion and needed no special implementation. I'm optimistic that Fusion Forms already offer almost all the features of the YAML forms. However, I must admit that we likely missed some, especially the exotic ones. Did you know that YAML forms could theoretically be used from the command line? I did not until some weeks ago, and I fear Fusion Forms will not be able to do this anytime soon. It would be great if you would use the extensibility of the Fusion Form package to help us fill in the gaps that a totally fresh package obviously has. So here are some project ideas for you. Since it is a quasi-standard, it would be great to have a recapture package with a custom field type and a recapture validator. There are also some quite common newsletter subscription services around. It would be great to have actions for those as well. Also, it would be great to have an action that persists submitted data and allows editor to browse and export it from the backend. There already is a package from Punkt.de which does this for YAML forms. Maybe this package can be extended. For the ambitious ones, I recommend trying to port the Form Builder package to Fusion. This package implements editor-defined forms made out of nodes. The needed interfaces are already in place, so it should be totally possible. If you are afraid of this topic, let's talk about sponsoring for that. I would be interested to implement it, but I will definitely not do it in my spare time. Also, I'm really curious whether someone will implement a custom process implementation. I'm quite sure there's more than single and multi-step form processes, but I really have no clue what those will be about. Which dependencies are needed for Fusion Forms? Is NEOS 7.1 a requirement? Actually, no. If you only need the form rendering, your only requirement is Fusion Form 1, which is compatible with NEOS versions as old as 4.3. For the runtime functionality, you have to require Fusion Form 2, which supports NEOS starting from version 5. So, if your project is actively maintained, you should be able to use Fusion Forms right away. While being new, Fusion Form already has quite a bit of documentation. The main entry point to all references, examples, and tutorials for now is the package README on GitHub or Packagist. In the not-so-distant future, we obviously will integrate them into the NEOS docs. As mentioned before, NEOS Demo, as it comes with NEOS 7.1, contains a very basic example for a contact form node type based on the Fusion Form runtime. So if you need a working example, you can use that as a blueprint. If you need further help, there is a dedicated channel in the NEOS Slack, but of course, you can also use the generic NEOS channels as well. There is definitely room for improvement here, so it would be cool if some of you would review those documentations, fill in the gaps, or even write tutorials suitable for beginners. After working on a topic for a long time, it gets really hard to imagine what prior knowledge to expect for a basic tutorial, so I did not even try that. Does the Fusion Form package contain bugs? Of course. The development was quite a journey and all parts were written and refactored about 3 times. However, a thing that makes me quite optimistic is that Fusion Form uses roughly a third of the PHP lines which were previously involved. So even if the probability of bugs is obviously higher in fresh code, there are still way less places to hide. The main method that controls the runtime form has just 20 lines of PHP, and this already includes commands. A place that still needs improvement is testing. There are unit tests and functional tests for the domain objects. And there is static code analysis with PHP Stun, which is as strict as possible. But there are no end-to-end tests yet, since Fusion prototypes are really hard to test. Because of that, one of the next tasks I personally want to play around with is a testing framework for Fusion. Once this will be available, we will be able to increase the test coverage of Fusion Form eventually. What else will the future bring? In the near future, I expect that there will be newer and better versions of Fusion Form with less bugs and probably those features that we overlooked in the first releases. I hope that the packages that implemented additional field types and finishers will be ported from Neos Form to Fusion Form quite fast. I do not expect this to happen within weeks, but I also doubt it will take years. I hope that someone will also attack the node-based form topic, or we find sponsors to do it ourselves. For now, the Fusion Form package is developed as a separate package outside of the Neos development collection, which allows us to make releases independent of Neos releases whenever necessary. For the moment, that is an advantage. In the long run, I expect that Fusion Form will be moved to the Neos development collection just like AFX. With the ability to create custom backend modules with Fusion rendering, I expect that Neos will start to use Fluid less and less, and hopefully one day it will be possible to have a Neos that does not need Fluid at all. But this is definitely some years away. Even then, you can expect that Fluid will still be available as a templating option. So if you like Fluid, there is no technical need to switch. There are no plans to deprecate it anytime soon. Same goes for YAML forms. If it works for you, there is no need to change it. The package is not going anywhere, and there are no plans to deprecate it for the foreseeable future. But if you struggled with YAML forms in the past, or you were reluctant of adopting AFX because it did not cover forms yet, now is the time to give it a shot. Thank you, and have fun with Fusion Form.
Well, and I'd like to give that back. Thank you, Martin, for presenting all these concepts, but also, of course, working on this big feature update for Neos. I think that's something lots of people have waited for. And as with most guests today, we're happy to have Martin connected with us. Hi, Martin.
Hello.
Hi.
Thanks for having me.
Yeah, greetings to Hamburg. So, the obvious question for me is, what motivated you to take up on this task, and why only now and not 5 years ago?
To be honest, I didn't start it immediately after we introduced AFX because I just was intimidated.
Yeah.
Because of all the complexity, and I really hoped someone who actually knew what he was doing would do it. But it turns out probably I had to be the one, which is maybe if you start something like AFX, you have to finish it. So I looked into it and I started slowly because I couldn't have started with the runtime functionality. So I started with form rendering and looked what Flow did in the past, which was also very helpful since I always could decide what was already a good existing way, which had proven to work, and do in Fusion what was done in Fluid, and that gave me a good guideline. So
yeah.
And from that, I continued. step by step.
So you did some kind of archaeology, so discovering the existing features, and you also mentioned you found mechanisms or features you didn't know about before. So what was that a good way to get to know the inner workings of flow and forms and that, like, in general?
Totally, and there are also some quite smart things in there which you only discover when you really dig deep, and I can totally recommend, if you are really working on a topic, you learn to know your subject deeply, and afterwards you may be really able to see the whole topic differently. And in the end, I wrote all this almost 3 times because I never was satisfied. Mm-hmm. And just after the second rewrite, when I started the third one, all the bricks fell in place, and I was actually able to say, that's how it's meant to be. So.
Yeah. Yeah, nice. You mentioned some ideas for future features. One thing I don't know about it yet, but is it possible to do something like image uploads, like and probably displaying a thumbnail? Is there some way to do that with Neos Fusion Forms yet?
There's no built-in thing yet. There are uploads are supported. Mm-hmm. And if you have a resource, you can render an image. So it would be possible. You would use AFX and to just create an image tag. Mm-hmm. But of course, especially in that regard, there can be things improved and things can become easier. Yeah. But I felt it was a bit too opinionated to add image previews directly to the upload field, because can be used for many different things.
And you have all the power of Fusion at your hand, so you can probably render whatever preview you like. Talking about preview, how do forms feel like for the editor in the Neos UI? When you look at these forms, are they like, can you actually use them while you're in the backend, or are they disabled, or how do they behave for an editor?
It's mainly up to you. Usually, thing depends. We integrated in the into Neos demo is not active in the backend, so it's not interactive because it's not inline editable. But you could do that, and submitting forms from the backend is probably not a good idea, but nothing speaks against it. So it's just, but building forms from nodes, which may be interesting, but I have also seen bad things done by editors in the past. So I suggest to be careful with that.
Yeah, me as well.
I do have a question from the chat. So Martin, Bastian Weidelich wants to know, why is the process type a string, and where to configure the corresponding implementation? Did he get that right?
Yes. It can the process.
But he always asks these tough questions.
He's really paying attention.
I think I think you can use a class name in there as well. It's an identifier which can be a class name, and process type. You mean the action type, which because the process
yes
is
no.
A Fusion prototype.
It depends.
Yeah. No, the action type is a string because it should be easy to implement a custom action without implementing a Fusion prototype. So you just have to implement a PHP class. And the identifier, if you put an identifier, it will be mapped to a class name internally, but you can also directly add a custom class name as long as it implements the action interface. So it's meant to be easy to extend, and so you don't have to mess with implementing a Fusion prototype.
Okay.
Awesome.
So just to reiterate, the packages. There are lots of forms related packages. So just to get clear, which packages should you use now and which should you avoid if you want to be modern?
I would only use NEOS Fusion Form from now.
Okay.
But that's me.
And so. And that's the package you need, right?
Okay. That's the package you need, and everything else. There will probably one day be a package that adds defining forms by nodes. Mm-hmm. Additionally, because we do not want you will have the option to install it or not on your system. But for now, it's just NEOS Fusion Form.
Okay, I can memorize that. That's easy enough for me. Okay.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Martin, for taking the time this Saturday to talk with us. And also, of course, thanks a lot for your big contribution with this package, right? Thank you.
Yeah. Have a nice conference. See you soon.